Hello, my dear friends in Carmel. I'm Brother Dominic of the Eucharist. Today, I would like to introduce to you a very young and beautiful Carmelite saint of our modern times. She was canonized recently on 1993 by our beloved Saint John Paul II. Her name is Teresa of Jesus. Is it sound familiar? Of course, this is not about our Holy Mother, Saint Teresa Avila. We also call her Saint Teresa of Jesus. This is about Saint Teresa of Jesus of Los Andes, the first Chilean and the first member of the Theresian Carmel in Latin America is canonized. So who is this new Saint Teresa of Jesus? She was born in Santiago de Chile exactly 120 years ago on July 13, 1900 and baptized with the name Juana. Our people often call her Juanita, but she lived here on earth for less than 20 years. For she passed from this world to her Heavenly Father on the evening of April 12, 1920, only 3 months about her 20th birthday. But this young girl, though her life was short, she did a marvelous job that the church canonized her to become saint. What did exactly she do that in a very short time of life, she became the model of any of us here on earth? The answer is very simple. She chose Jesus above everything else. In her spiritual writings, Teresa of Los Andes wrote, and I quote, "Jesus alone is beautiful. He is my only joy. I call for him. I cry after him. I search for him within my heart. He is my unending wealth, my bliss, my heaven." That's why at a very young age, when she was only 14, under God's inspiration, she decided to consecrate herself to him as a religious in the Discarded Carmelite nuns. I guess you know there is another very famous saint also wanted to become a Carmelite nun at that very young age. Yes, that is Therese of the Child Jesus. Both of them, Teresa of Los Andes and Therese of Lisieux, have many things in common. They both came from a very wealthy family, young and beautiful, but they disregarded what the world considered as advantage to have a happy and comfortable life. Yet they chose the better part. They chose Jesus above everything else. At the age of 19, after Therese finished her college at the French nuns at the Sacred Heart, she officially entered the tiny monastery of the Carmelite nuns in the town of Los Andes. From here, though with a very short time, her mystical journey to Jesus became vivid. It seems she did not walk, but fly to Jesus. In one of her visions, Jesus revealed to her that she will be with him soon. In fact, she died even 6 months before she could finish her 1 year canonical novitiate and to be legally able to make her religious profession. But because of danger of death and her sanctity, she was approved and made her solemn profession only 5 days before she was to depart this life on the evening of April 12, 1920. So what made her life become so extraordinary that Saint Pope John Paul II beatified her on 1987? And only 6 years later, he again, on behalf of the Universal Church, canonized her saint. In this very short video, I cannot give you more about this beautiful life of Saint Teresa of Los Andes. I myself have to discover more, to learn more from her. So I humbly ask you, my dear friends, in Carmel, if you have time, in the comfort of your room, you can search for her in the internet. I'm sure even you just type her name, Teresa of Los Andes, you have a lot of beautiful information about her. There is even a very beautiful and touching movie about her that makes me almost cry when I watch it. One thing I know for sure, my dear friends, she is a certain proof that Jesus born to be holy, to be saints, is indeed real. It happens even in our time. It is worth our effort, and it gives us true happiness in life. On her birthday today, we may ask her to intercede for us before God in order to love Jesus and our neighbors more. May God, through His mercy and love, always be with us. Amen.